Thank you, thank you. Thank you very much. You know, The Rime of the Ancient Mariner by Samuel Taylor Coleridge, Trees by Joyce Kilmer, The New Colossus by Emma Lazarus, which is found at the base of the Statue of Liberty, by the way. Poetry is pervasive, and it's almost as old as time itself. But just as important as the poem is the interpretation. How it's delivered can mean everything. The students you are about to meet chose poems that spoke to them and performed them in Westerville's Poetry Out Loud contest. We're going to hear some of those poems and meet some of those bright and articulate young people next on this edition of
School's Out!
Thank you. Welcome to 2014's first installment of
School's Out!
Today we have the privilege of meeting five high school students from Westerville Central who competed in this year's Poetry Out Loud. We'll meet the winner of that competition and find out how she fared at the state level. So please welcome our first two guests. Ms. Cargan teaches cultural studies in literature and AP literature at Central, and she's one of the organizers of the competition. Please welcome Bridget Cargan. Tarike Oswobene is a junior who likes singing, reading, and playing the violin. She's also this year's winner of Poetry Out Loud. Please welcome Tarike. All right, just want to talk with you for just a second, Bridget, to find out what all is involved in organizing this contest and what's it all about.
Poetry Out Loud is a national competition, and we brought it to Central probably 6 or 7 years ago. The first year, I think we had 2 or 3 contestants, and they didn't know their poems very well. It wasn't a very strong competition, and we've just grown it every year. So now we have classroom competitions, so students can compete against each other a little bit, and then anyone who would like to compete in our school competition can do so. And every year we've gotten more contestants and really better contestants, so we had a lot of competition this year.
Fantastic. And how long have you personally been involved with the competition?
This is probably my 4th or 5th year being involved, and then the last few years I've taken maybe a bigger role in organizing.
And how long have you been teaching at Central?
This is my 6th year.
And did you teach somewhere else before that?
I taught 6 years at Westerville North many years ago.
From North to Central. Mm-hmm. And about the time, it was almost shortly after it opened then that you
moved
to Central. Hasn't been around that long.
Right. I think we're in our 11th year.
And how do you like it?
I love it.
Yeah, I think so. And the students love it, too, because my daughter was one of them, and she just loves you to death. So, and I don't know if you remember it, but you presented her diploma to her a couple of years ago.
It was quite an honor.
So I always got to get a plug for Abby. You know how the parent
Absolutely.
Thing goes. So, all right. And now, sitting next to you is Tarike Oswobene. Am I close?
Yes.
Good. Very good. All right, Tarike. You told me you had a brother in this competition.
Yes, he actually won last year.
He won last year, so you it's in the family. But you also said you weren't going to do it.
Yeah. After going to nationals and after hearing him perform, I told myself that I'm not going to do this. Like, I'm not going to be compared or have any trouble with that. So
just don't keeping up with your brother, famous brother, is going to be kind of hard, right?
Yeah.
Well, what changed your mind? When did you decide?
Well, Ms. Cargan told me to do it, and I was still reluctant, but I just figured that I'd do it, that I was kind of, as I started to do it more, I liked it a lot more, and I actually found myself at the school competition hoping that I'd be one of the finalists so that I could hopefully have a chance to go to the state. So as I did it more, I started to like it a lot more.
Did you watch your brother compete last year?
Yes, I did.
Okay, so you were kind of proud of him then, too?
Yeah, yeah.
And you said, I could never do that.
Right, yeah, kind of.
Okay, and he went on to state. He won and went on to states.
Mm-hmm.
How did he do there?
He did at states.
Yeah.
He won states. At the national level,
wow.
He got honorable mention.
That's amazing. What's his name? Let's show a plug for him.
Taribo Oswobene.
Taribo.
Taribo.
Taribo, okay, so that's great. He went on to nationals. Fantastic. How did you come about finding a poem that kind of spoke to you?
I honestly just looked through the website and I found one. And the first one I found was A Song in the Front Yard. It's kind of talking about being rebellious and breaking out of like such a routine that you get in, like living your whole life this way, but you're trying to break out and maybe be a little rebellious and that kind of thing.
Did you like poetry? Did you know any poetry before you decided to do this?
Not really, no.
Not really. So you just kind of sort of searched the web and found something that spoke to you?
Yeah.
And you also, I was looking at you also plan to go to college out of state, still in the Midwest somewhere, so you're considering Pennsylvania, Georgetown, University of Michigan, those are all good schools.
Yeah.
And what do you think you want to do there?
Well, I like literature and I like history and government, so maybe a lawyer, maybe something in that field, but I'm not too sure yet.
Not too sure yet, but that's fine, you know, at how old are you, 16, 17? And yeah, you got plenty of time to figure that out, right?
Yeah.
I didn't know what I wanted to do at the age of 39, so, you know, it happens. You change things up. So you finally decided to do it this year. Were you nervous?
I was very nervous.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's kind of hard, especially because you perform. I remember when Abby was in it, there's just a group of people sort of in the library or something. Is it, mm-hmm. you still do it in the library?
Yeah.
And it's mostly people you know and that are also going to be reading poems, right? Mm-hmm. So that's kind of nervous. How do you calm your nerves?
I don't know. I don't really have a way to do it. I just kind of go up there and hope
do your thing.
Yeah.
After you read it, they still do two poems, or did you just do one in the local competition?
In the local competition, we had to do one. Mm-hmm. At our next level, we had to do our second poem.
Your second one, okay. Mm-hmm. And after you did it, did you say, "Oh, I think I nailed it," or was like, "I don't know"?
After the final school competition, I was very worried because I messed up a line, and I was worried that was gonna just take me out completely.
Okay. And Bridget, were you also judging, or did you hire other people to judge?
Yes.
Okay. What are you looking for when you judge the competition?
There's a lot of things like stage presence and like appropriateness and delivery, but I think the most important thing is, do you properly convey the poem?
Okay.
Are we able to see that you understand what it means, and do we believe that you relate to what the speaker is saying?
Okay, so there's a lot of it involved. And how many judges do you have generally?
At the first level of the school competition, I think we had five or six, and mm-hmm. then when we got down to these five finalists, we had four of us.
So you have an idea what they're looking for in state, and you try to kind
mm-hmm.
of look
exactly.
for the same look for the
yes,
same
we use the same criteria, we use the same rubric.
Okay. Now, Tarika, do you have something prepared for us today?
Yes, I do.
Is this the poem you delivered at local or state or?
Yeah, I delivered both.
Would you like to hear Tarika's poem? Okay, all right, what is it called?
It's called I'm a Fool to Love You.
Okay, it's all yours.
Can I stand up for it?
Oh, you can stay seated, that's fine.
I can
fine.
Stay seated?
Mm-hmm.
Can I stand up if I want to, or?
Well, can we follow if she stands up? Yeah, the cameraman's telling me yes, so we'll follow.
I'm a Fool to Love You by Cornelius Eady. Some folks will tell you the blues is a woman, some type of supernatural creature. My mother would tell you, if she could, about her life with my father, a strange and sometimes cruel gentleman. She would tell you about the choices a young black woman faces. Is falling in love with some man a deal with the devil? In blue terms, the tongue we use when we don't want nuance to get in the way, when we need to talk straight. My mother chooses my father after choosing a man who was, as we sing it, of no account. This man made my father look good. That's how bad it was. He made my father seem like an island in the middle of a stormy sea. He made my father look like a rock. And is the blues the moment you realize you exist in a stacked deck? You look in a mirror at your young face, the face my sister carries, and you know it's the only leverage you've got. Does this create a hurt that whispers, how are you going to do? is the blues the moment you shrug your shoulders and agree. A girl without money is nothing, dust, to be pushed around by any old breeze. Compared to this, my father seems, briefly, to be a fire escape. This is the way the blues works, its sorry wonders. Makes trouble look like a feather bed. Makes the wrong man's kisses a healing.
Yeah. Fantastic. There's your award winner at this year's Poetry Out Loud. We're going to take a break right now, but when we come back, we'll meet two more Poetry Out Loud students, and we'll hear their favorite works, too. We'll be back on...
School's Out!
Great. I know.
Where are you headed?
I'm just going to hang out.
With Gary and Todd?
Yeah.
I've been meaning to ask you, is there any drinking going on in this crowd?
No.
If any of your buddies ever pressure you to take a drink, just tell them you promised your dad you wouldn't.
I'd do anything to keep you safe.
Okay, I will.
I hope this is working.
I promise. Love you too, Dad.
They really do hear you. For tips on what to say, visit underagedrinking.samhsa.gov.
My team depends on me.
And my team is 50,000 strong.
This is what it feels like to be part of a team.
A winning team.
The Action Team.
Get in on the action at actionteam.org. Are you in?
Help support the Breast Cancer Patient Education Act, a bill that will help make sure women facing a mastectomy are told all their options about breast reconstruction. Visit BraDayUSA.org for more information.
When doctors told me I would never walk again, somehow I knew I would. Whether you need support in a tragedy or just to make it through a bad day, prayer can make a difference. America, let's come together by believing with each other.
I realized at that moment, these people really needed us. And I was going to make a difference right here in my community.
Be there for your community at NationalGuard.com.
If you or your organization are involved in an interesting extracurricular activity and you would like to be a guest on Schools Out, you can call 823-1563 or email to jdemus@otterbein.edu. Please leave your name, the name of the school you or your students attend, a brief description of your activity, and a number or email where we can reach you. Schools Out is a WOCC studio production.
Welcome back to this edition of
Schools Out!
We have two more guests who have just joined us in the studio. To my far left is Alex McDowell, and Alex is a senior at Central and hopes to go into the Air Force as a cyber systems analyst. He likes computers, obviously, video games, obviously, and reading, writing, and physics. Please welcome Alex McDowell. And seated next to me, next to Alex, is Abby Jokerst. And Abby is also a senior. She loves animals, playing trumpet and acoustic guitar, and wants to attend the University of Findlay to major in animal science and biology. Please welcome Abby Jokerst. Let's start with you, Abby, because we have so many things in common. You, of course, know that I have an Abby, and she graduated a couple years ago. You did theater with her, didn't you?
I did, for a year.
Okay. Do you remember any plays you were in together or anything?
Yeah, I remember the musical, You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown, but I especially remember the children's play. And I remember afterwards that she kind of talked to me and was praising towards how I did.
Good, yeah, because I was at that children's play, and I remembered when I saw your name come up there, I said, I know that name, so I texted her and said, yeah, she was in the children's play and Charlie Brown, and she had a lot of fun doing that. Theater's fun, isn't it?
Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
Are you still involved in theater, or are you doing anything? Or?
No, I don't really have a lot of time in my schedule to do it.
Understood. But are you still playing the trumpet and or acoustic guitar? Or?
Yeah.
Okay, did you play trumpet in marching band, right?
Yes, I did.
Okay, what about guitar? What kind of music do you like to play?
I just play the songs that I like the most, some from Glee or Beatles.
You gotta love Glee. You gotta play some Glee songs. Okay, and you also have another thing in common. You plan on attending University of Findlay, and that's where my Abby goes. So hopefully she can show you around a little bit there. Yeah. So have you visited the campus yet?
Yes.
It's a great looking campus, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think you'll have fun there. And they're all into animals. They're all about equine science and stuff like that. What kind of animals do you like?
I like all kinds of animals. I like dogs, cattle, horses, wild, a lot of kinds.
Lots of different kinds. Yeah. So it'll be fun. And biology. So you want to be a vet someday?
Yeah.
That would be fun. Because what could be better if you love animals than helping them get better, right?
So, right.
Yeah. Okay. And do you have something prepared for us today?
I do.
Okay. Is this the one you did at the local competition?
Yes.
Okay. Take it away, Abby. Would you like to hear Abby's poem?
Okay. Bereavement by William Lyle Bowles. Whose was that gentle voice, that whispering sweet? Promise me, thought, long days of bliss sincere. Soothing it stole on my deluded ear, most like soft music, that might sometimes cheat, thoughts dark and drooping. 'Twas a voice of hope, of love, and social scenes. It seemed to speak of truth, of friendship, of affection meek. That, oh, poor friend, might to life's downward slope lead us in peace and bless our latest hours. Ah, me. The prospect saddened as she sung. Loud on my startled ear, the death bell rung. Chilled darkness wrapped the pleasurable bowers, whilst horror, pointing to yon breathless clay, no peace be thine, exclaimed, away, away. Thank you.
Beautiful. All right, Alex, you, after high school, want to go into the Air Force.
Yep.
And work with us as a cyber systems analyst. We're talking robotics here?
Something like that.
Okay, explain what cyber systems is all about.
Well, basically, from what I understand at least, my original thing was IT, but cyber systems is kind of a lot like that from what I understand. And basically, you just, you know, you work with computers and you just analyze cyber systems and, you know, security networks and mainframes and servers and all that type of deal. So,
yeah. Okay, so obviously you go beyond just being a user then. You like to find out what makes it work, what makes networks work and things like that. What kind of things have you done just hobby-wise or playing around with computers?
Well, I like to go in the command prompt a lot. I like to get into that just because it's
right at the root level. Right?
Yeah, that started it all. I like to program Java, HTML, dabble in some jQuery and, you know, PHP, but, you know, that's basically what I do in my free time.
Guess what? I think I hear there's a future in that somewhere because computers might be around.
Maybe.
Might be around for a while. So, let's see. What are your favorite video games?
Dark Souls is my absolute favorite.
Dark Souls?
Dark Souls, yes.
Okay.
It's a beautiful game.
And what's the premise there?
You're an undead. You're right before you're about to go hollow. This guy throws a key, and you get cursed with the dark sign, which means if you die, you come back to life, and it's basically an impossibly hard game, but I love it.
That's pretty much my Friday night you just described there. you mentioned Call of Duty also. That's a popular one. I know. I hear Call of Duty all the time.
Yeah, it's popular, but I play it competitively, so I play
for
the money.
You've been in tournaments. Have you ever won anything, or what's the best you've done?
I mean, yeah, I've won tournaments, you know, small little tournaments, nothing big, you know. There was a LAN that was delayed, that was a 2K LAN. That's going to be next month, so. Okay.
And you have something prepared for us today?
I actually do.
All right, we want to hear Alex's poem. Take it away, Alex McDowell.
Traveling Through the Dark by William E. Stafford. Traveling Through the Dark, I found a deer, dead on the edge of the Wilson River Road. It is normally best to roll them into the canyon. That road is narrow. To swerve might make more dead. By the glow of the taillight, I stumbled back of the car and stood by the heap. A doe. A recent killing. I dragged her away. She was large in the belly. My fingers touching her side brought me the reason. Her side was warm. Her fawn lay there waiting. Alive, still, never to be born. Beside that mountain road, I hesitated. I stood in the glare of the warm exhaust, turning red. Under the hood purred the steady engine. Around our group, I could hear the wilderness listen. Beside that mountain road, I hesitated. I thought hard for us all, my only swerving, then pushed her over the edge into the river.
Yeah. Very nice. Very nice. All right, we're going to step aside one more time for a moment and return with the last of our guests from this year's Poetry Out Loud. Stay with us on
School's Out!
Where do you think you're going?
Is your body holding you back?
I want to go running. Not with that knee, you're not. I'm fine. Negative.
Your bones and joints can say no at any age.
With that shoulder, you're going to pick up that track. Really?
Keeping you from working, playing, or just plain moving.
That's not a picker up, what do you say?
Yet a lot of people who live with pain fight back.
Use your head. Save your back.
My bride, my rules.
And regain their lives.
You gotta be kidding me.
Whoa. I'm going running.
I'm going running.
I got to see this. Come on, pick it up.
Fight for your mobility. Find your own inspiration at anationinmotion.org. A message from the American Academy of Orthopedic Surgeons.
Come on.
I'll take it from here.
All right, welcome back to a very exciting edition of We've been talking with Westerville Central students who have competed in this year's Poetry Out Loud contest, a national contest. They competed at the local level. Seated now to my left is Ansley Thomas, and she's a senior. She likes reading a good book, watching Turner Classic Movies, and listening to oldies on the radio. Please welcome Ansley Thomas. And seated next to Ansley is Nick Gentile. He's also a senior. He likes working on computers and playing paintball, and plans on attending Bowling Green State University. Say hello to Nick Gentile. Okay, I got to hear about this, Ansley. I know you like a lot of people like a good book, but Turner Classic Movies. So you know all the old Casablanca and all that stuff.
Yeah.
That's marvelous. Did your parents get you excited?
Yeah, my mom likes to turn it on when we're just like doing laundry or anything. So
okay.
It really got me into movies and watching old movies and quality stuff. And
all right, so what are your favorite old movies?
I recently watched Casablanca, and I love Casablanca.
Yeah.
It's
Louis, I think this is the beginning of a beautiful friendship. That's my terrible Humphrey Bogart impression. Okay, but a great movie.
Yeah.
What else? Anything else?
I like The Dirty Dozen.
Dirty Dozen. Oh, Jim Brown and all. Oh, yeah, it's a great movie. Great movie. That's generally considered a male-oriented movie that most guys talk about that.
Yeah.
But you liked it, huh?
Yes, I did.
Okay. And oldies on the radio. So do you live in the present at all, or you go get back for the oldies on the radio, too?
What era are we talking about? I listen to a lot of different music. Oldies. When I was little, we always listened to Tom Petty and The Police and Pink Floyd.
Okay.
And so I always listen to that on the radio.
Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers.
Yes.
Free fall. And I'm not going to sing either. We've already heard my bad Humphrey Bogart impression. Well, that's great. I mean, it's always great. I was influenced by my parents' music and things, too. So, yeah, I got turned on to a lot of old stuff like that. And Nick, you're a senior, and you plan on attending the College of Business at Bowling Green State University. You like working on computers also. Now, just from the gaming playing side, or do you also like to be involved in the hardware or firmware end of it?
Well, yeah, it's sort of like that. Like last summer, for instance, I built my own gaming computer because I said,
"Wow,
I'm cheap and I don't want to have to But it's fun to do, sort of get into the systems and try to make it work better, just see what that does. And yeah, I play a lot of games on that too. Okay. So.
And paintball is another interest. Now, that's the first one I've heard, a really grueling outdoor activity. Instead of just Call of Duty, you're actually getting out there and doing it. What do you like about paintball?
Well, paintball is, in its own right, just really fun because you get to shoot other people with balls of paint. I mean,
and it doesn't hurt. Nobody really gets hurt, do they?
Okay, well, that's debatable. But
sometimes, if you're at close range, it can hurt a little bit.
It's safe.
Okay.
But that doesn't stop it from hurting. But it's just really fun to get out there and, especially with your friends, and just run around and, you know, try to work as a team a lot.
Yeah.
It's just really fun.
Yeah. See, in the old days, we used to play army, and we'd sometimes use golf clubs or old plastic, and that's all we got to do. We never had any paintball stuff, so. That sounds really cool. I've never played it, but it sure looks like a whole lot of fun.
Can be.
All right. Ansley, do you have something prepared for us today?
I do.
Okay, we want to hear Ansley's poem. All right, take it away.
Death, be not proud, though some have called thee mighty and dreadful, for thou art not so. For those whom thou thinkest thou dost overthrow, die not, poor death, nor yet canst thou kill me. From rest and sleep, which but thy pictures be, much pleasure, and then from thee much more must flow. And soonest our best men with thee do go, rest their bones and soul's delivery. Thou art slave to fate, chance, kings, and desperate men, and doth with poison, war, and sickness dwell. And poppy our charms can make us sleep as well, and better than thy stroke. Why swellest thou then? One short sleep past, and we wake eternally. And death shall be no more. Death, thou shalt die.
Okay, that's a famous poem. I'm gonna embarrass myself here. Is it Elizabeth Barrett Browning? No, it's not Elizabeth Barrett Browning.
Don John.
Who is it?
John Donne.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it wasn't a famous author. Okay, but I know that poem, Death Be Not Proud.
Yes.
I think we've all heard it. Great job, great rendition of that.
Thank
what
you.
Made you choose that?
My mother likes that poem a lot.
Okay.
She had a tragic death in her family when she was really young.
Yeah, that's tough, but it speaks to it really well, doesn't it? Okay. All right, we're ready to hear Nick's poem. Take it away, Nick.
All right. Invictus by William Ernest Henley. Out of the night that covers me, black as the pit from pole to pole, I thank whatever gods may be for my unconquerable soul. In the fell clutch of circumstance, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the bludgeonings of chance, my head is bloody, but unbowed. Beyond this place of wrath and tears looms but the horror of the shade, and yet the menace of the years finds and shall find me unafraid. It matters not how straight the gate, how charged with punishments the scroll. I am the master of my fate. I am the captain of my soul. Thank you.
All right. We are out of time, but we want to thank you for joining us today. We want to thank all our guests, their families and friends for being here, and especially Ms. Cargan for getting them all together. On behalf of the entire WOCC crew, thanks for watching. See you next time on
Schools Out!